Hey, you. Yes, you. We all play a game on this, right? And we all know we suffer from the same damn thing. Your neck is hurting. Your phone can just run out battery and you lose an important RTA match or you stop farming. How do you stop farming? Or you have an amazing gaming setup at home. You want to play your favorite mobile game on your gaming PC. I have a solution for you. The Mumu app player. It is an amazing emulator to play your favorite mobile games on your PC. I use it every single day to play Summoners on stream or make YouTube video. A lot of people have been asking me what emulator do I use. I always say Mumu. For free, your boy reached out to Mumu and they were kind enough to sponsor us. So I have a link down below for you to download Mumu app player. It is really smooth to play Summoners on, which is not very compatible with emulator. Later, you can use it to play other mobile games and they're really, really smooth. And there's even a setting where you can push it to 120 FPS. Imagine losing an RTA in 120 FPS on your gaming PC. What's better than that? So if you want to support the channel, you can use the link down below to download Mumu. It's really good. I use it every day. Hey guys, SeanB. Today we are taking a look at Chow, the Water Dragon Knight after the recent balance patch. They give him a pretty good buff. But in my opinion, it was not a buff that's gonna bring him out of the storage for many, many people. And it's not like a buff that will make him meta like how Jogun just came out of nowhere and sealed every competition away. His passive will now allow him to cleanse the debuff at the start of the turn. Only one debuff though, not everything. And also heal at the start of the turn. His damage will scale with his current HP. So this passive makes perfect sense. At the start of the turn, if you have attack break or glancing, you'll be cleansed of that and you heal back a little bit to do more damage that scale with your current HP. In the past, it cleansed at the end of the turn, which makes no sense and he suck. And now he can also cleanse stun or sleep or freeze, which is amazing. But when you want to use a water bruiser unit, there's a very, very big elephant in the room. And that is Vigor. He's still one of the most overused guild content unit because of his amazing base stat and base speed, and he has a lot of utility in his kit, and he's just really, really good overall, and everybody can use his unit. So even after the nerf to his skill 3 cooldown, he is still one of the strongest guild content unit right now. And when you need like a strong water tank unit, Camilla often comes to mind. So to me, Chow's like a neither here or there situation. He's still a fun toy to use. If you have him, you want to build him. He awakens to crit rate, which make him easier to ruin and have high crit rate. I'm using speed, crit damage, HP. He's still okay. But is he the best for any situation in the game? I wouldn't say so. I think the best buff that he got in this patch was the fact that he can now cleanse the stun. So wind unit that can stun, like let's say Tyrannus or Ethna, they won't be stunning Chow or controlling Chow that easily anymore. And if he get defense break, he can cleanse it pretty much immediately. And I think he fit into like a sort of bruiser style comp while he takes some damage and can still do some pretty good damage right there. You see 27,000 on a skill 2, very low cooldown as well. He is not bad at all. Actually gonna try to see the damage from the Lyca after this, so I'm gonna do this. Hopefully he doesn't stun the Lyca though, and hopefully he doesn't provoke the Lyca. Okay, no provoke. Ah, he violent proc, never mind. What do we do here? I'm gonna try to kill the Perna maybe. Let me put this up. I think Lyca gonna take some hit here, which is really unfortunate. Bam, miss a crit right there, unfortunate as well. Let's just focus on the Perna for now. 17,000 or skill 2 on the Perna right there. That's not too bad at all. That is not too bad at all. I want to see the damage of them, but in similar condition. But nobody here is giving me a chance to do anything. So with Violent Prong, Chow can do some pretty solid damage. And he healed back, so you don't have to care about healing for him that much. Because the healing is quite substantial. Big damage on the Tyrannus. 15k, not bad, not bad. Can I see a Chow good old crit? Never mind, just kidding. Just kidding. I saw 12k earlier on the Molong. So let's see the damage from the Lyca. Oh, we're not gonna get that anytime soon. Okay, can you finish that? Almost. Okay, we're gonna do Never mind, can't see the damage side by side. I can set up the perfect scenario, but I want to see in actual combat, you know? So in this situation right here, so you have two debuff, right? Well, let's see which one is going to cleanse. Let me try the defense break this guy. Okay. Three debuff. So he chose to cleanse the stun, which is amazing. But he can choose to cleanse the defense break and you're still stunned after that. So let me try to go for big damage here. Never mind. Can I go for big damage here? Boom. 29,000. Not bad. So he's getting focused right now. And as you can see, if that was like a Camilla, I think the defense break would have been cleansed by the Vigor. But because the fact that you can't cleanse in the middle of the turn, you still get pretty much destroyed if you get defense broken and focus on like that. Okay, he cleansed. Very, very nice. I'm trying to go for damage here. Nice violent. We can actually kill the Vigor. The good thing about this skill is you ignore shield, and it is still a very common mechanic in Guild Wars content. So being able to ignore shield makes him very, very good against Camoon and Vigor. He also ignore anti-crit, but I don't have max crit, so we're going crit just now. We get stun here, but the stun doesn't matter. We get a nice cleanse there. So in this regard, this is one of the best buff to him because yeah, he just ignored the dumb stun that Ethna put on him all the time, and the defense break is gone as well. Finish her? Okay, thank you. Not bad. So in this 1v1 situation, a lot of people would lose to Camoon, but not Chow. You don't even need destroy because every time you hit him, you do so much damage. I'm sorry. Every time you hit him, you do so much damage and you ignore the shield and you heal back a lot. So 1v1 against Camoon, if you have a Chow, you're in a good hand. Even with like a Vigor there, you might even kill the Vigor if you get a good violent prop. So in this kind of comp, so going to this kind of Camoon Vigor comp and a wind unit, trying to kill the wind unit quick, and Chow can sort of carry you to victory. But into this kind of setup, Chow might not be the most amazing thing because Camilla can tank better, but let's give it a try. So you want Chow to take some damage from the Odin, meaning when you're trying to kill the Tessarion, oh my god. Oh my god. Come on, Nemesis, I forgot. We're gonna do this. And meanwhile, we're trying our best to... Oh, the Nemesis kick in as well. We're trying our best to defense break this guy. Okay, looking pretty good. We're gonna eat a defense break here, potentially. Alright, no defense break. And maybe sleep this guy? No? Sleep? Okay. So in the past, you'll keep the glancing like this. But now the glancing is gone, so you can start doing damage to Cesarion. Boom. Good damage, nice violent heal back a little bit, boom. So, damn, today Chow's on fire with the violent prop, huh? And then you Oblivion this, and because Chow's usually built with like high HP, you can take a couple hit before you even need the trainer passive, and that is pretty awesome. So let me try to crit here. Just kidding, no crit. It is better to have a Whirlwind Triana. Just saying, I brought the wrong Triana. I have a Whirlwind Triana, but that's the other one, I forgot. But as you can see right there, Chow can be a good, decent water tank for the Odin. There are many other options as well, and Vigor might be one of them, but Vigor buff a lot, so that might not be a good thing to bring against Odin. And something that can heal every single turn, regardless of the condition of him, like, you know, stun or not, whatever, he's healing every single turn, which is amazing. Maybe, you know, Chow's a slightly better option than Vigor right here. And if you're a fan of Chow who can do bigger damage, then hey, this is the perfect scenario for you to bring in this bad boy here compared to using other water unit. Hey, good damage right there. Among the normal Dragon Knight, not the LD one, I think Leo is probably the most popular and favorite amongst the normal Dragon Knight. I just repeat myself because he counter, oh my god, he just died. Shit. How do I win this? I have no idea. Let me try to kill the damage dealer over there first. But I think we're in some sort of trouble. Leo is very popular because he countered the meta RTA team. So everywhere you see Leo leading the Dragon Knight Revolution. Revolution. Oh god. English, SeanB. But you don't really see much of Laika and Chow. You might see more Laika recently because of the SeanB YouTube video, or because of the Legend Tournament that happened recently with Laika just dominating the LD Dragon Knight. So that's one big use of Laika, dominating the LD Dragon Knight. So here we're stunned, a very typical RTA situation. and we can potentially get out of the stun state with the self-cleanse. But the thing about Chow is that he's very one-dimensional. So I think in a normal Ante setup, this is still gonna happen. You're still gonna get your attack bar pushed back, and you're still gonna get shit on by just the normal CC comp. Because the strongest control is not stun or sleep or freeze anymore. It is attack bar pushback and cooldown reduction. And that still can destroy Chow pretty easily, I would say. For those who are a big fan of Chow, I really, really want to hear your thoughts about how you like Chow before and after the change, and how are you using him? Because I'm not a big fan of Chow personally. I think he is alright. He's not like, I have to use, oh shit, almost got Beaven right there. But I think Leo's dead. Yep, I think Leo's dead. I think that's the whole point of having the sound in this defense, is to shit on Leo. But hey, let me know how you use your Chow, because I want to learn more from Chow user and how they really love Chow, because I don't think I'm going to see Chow anywhere in RTA soon. I think I'm going to see Chow being like the hard counter to any comp whatsoever. Like, he's going to remain as like a toy and not like a staple. Like, let's say you pick Vert into Savannah, you pick Leo into Savannah, you pick Camilla into Odin, you pick Rika into just whatever. Rika's good everywhere. You pick Juno into Rika, like hard counter status. I think Chow will just remain as a I pull Chow, and I'm gonna use him once in a while in guild content, and that's about it for Chow. Like, every time I need a water bruiser, Vigor just come to mind. Like, Vigor just appear and be like, use me, and not Chow. And I'm always gonna get convinced by Vigor, because of how versatile Vigor is. Oh god, Chow, come on man, come on, stop missing crits, buddy. Glancing defense break, yeah, because I don't know, after this will I still use Chow? I'm not too sure, because we're making a video, right? We try to make Chow's look good in many situations possible, but after playing with him, putting actually good runes on him, I'm still not super convinced. Like, can he win a retouch? He need destroy rune to win a retouch, probably. I think with destroy rune you can win a retouch, but without destroy rune and our defense breaker is gone, I don't think we are winning a retouch. Yeah, because he can self heal, right? With destroy rune maybe. But I like Nemesis a lot though, because he need to get a turn. He need to get a turn to cleanse himself, he need to get a turn to do stuff. How come I feel like I've been here before? A retesh against a Chow. Huh. I feel like I've seen this somewhere before, and it doesn't end well for the Chow user because of elemental disadvantage. How can Perna crit on water so easily? And look at my Chow. I'm barely critting this retesh. It's either I glancing or I don't crit. Right? I haven't seen a single crit for the past like 10 hits. We just don't crit, which is like normal. And finally a crit. Oh, that's some good damage though, I gotta say. So if we get a good crit and a back-to-back proc, maybe. But we're getting a good crit once every 10 hits. So thanks to the cleansing ability, we're not getting defense broken that easily. But yeah, I think with Destroy Rune, we're gonna win. So maybe Destroy is gonna be better than Nemesis. I just like Nemesis a lot, but you're gonna find yourself in this situation, and I think a Destroy Chow will win almost everything possible. Okay, we're good. Because you are so tanky and you heal every turn, you do good damage. Yeah, I think a Destroy Chow is like way better. Alright guys, but that's it for Chow today. Hopefully you're gonna see Chow in like RTA in the future, potentially in a bruiser comp, and hopefully he's gonna be somewhat useful in the next meta. We don't know what's gonna be just yet. We can only hope for Chow return to the RTA stage. For guild content, you can always run Chow, because there's always gonna be a strong wind unit out there trying to kill your water unit. So you run a tanky damage unit like Chow, then you don't have to think too much about survivability. He's not bad, but he's not that amazing. What do you guys think about Chow? Let me know in the comment section down below. Hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.